Okay, let's train our ears now to hear different chord types. And so for this lesson, I want to work on three chord types. I want to work on the major sound, I want to work on the minor sound, and the dominant sound. As I've mentioned in other lessons, a good 75% or more of the chords you're going to be seeing, going to be playing, going to be dealing with are either minor or major or dominant. Of course, there are other kinds of chords. We've already covered quite a few, and as you can see down my curriculum, there's all kinds of chords that are there at your disposal. But for where we are here, I want to make sure that you can hear and train yourself to hear these three different kinds of chords. So so give a listen. I want to play them on a piano a little bit. And I also want to play them on my horn so you can hear them linearly, because again, as a saxophone player, you want to make sure you're able to hear chords not just blocked, but also in a line, like a melody. So listen to the difference simply between this C chord and this chord. Not a lot of difference, right? Not a lot of difference in terms of what I'm playing, and not a lot of difference in terms of the notes, except for one. Being able to hear simply the difference between a major chord and a minor chord, as simple as that sounds, is super important. Obviously, if you're playing in a situation where there's no lead sheet, no indication of what the chord is, you want to be able to hear, as we did in our single note ear training, what the root is. But you also want to just be able to, without trying to figure out every note in the chord that's being played, what the chord type is. So you know, simple rule that I probably learned on the first day that I was taught to play anything that didn't involve this one note. When you hear a major chord, it sounds happy. I mean, doesn't it sound much happier? Does that sound very happy? whatever inversion. As opposed to, right, does it sound a little less happy? Right. So the minor chord sounds a little more sad. And so no matter what key it's in, it still has that sort of personality to it. Now, a dominant chord, it's a little trickier, because it has that major third, like a major chord does, but it has that flat seventh. So if I put the seventh down below, it's kind of that, how would you describe it? I describe that as being sort of quizzical sounding. Inversion. So as you listen to these chords, I mean, it sounds a little silly to think about major chords as happy and minor chords as sad, and dominant chords as pensive or questioning or different sort of names to put them on them. But that works for me. And you might have something else that you relate to. You might have a favorite song that's very major, and the chord that you're hearing reminds you of that song, as opposed to something that's very, very minor. Sometimes we just find these different ways of identifying chords, especially when they're blocked like that, that work. So when you're playing them on your horn and you're playing them linearly, like this, if I'm playing a G major triad, for instance, so one easy way to determine the chord, just like we did in the two note intervals, is to sing the scale. Ba, and if your major scale, or if you play along with a chord that you're hearing, it's another way to do it. And you play a major scale and all the notes fit, boom, it's a major chord. As long as you're sure that all the notes that you're playing are fitting that chord. So, And then the same thing with minor chords. If I play a minor, that was a triad, and this will be a triad as well, on my minor triad, my G minor triad. You can still relate that, you know, that emotion name to it. You know, the first scale, the first chord sounded happy-ish. If I add the seventh to it, sounds a little happier. If I play that same scale, the same chord, and then attach a scale to it, but in minor, this will be the minor seventh chord. You might think that's, you know, in the sad category, or, you know, but again, by singing the scale, the corresponding scale, if, you know, you might, hopefully you have some indication in your ear and in your head that, you know, that sounds a little more up to me. I'm guessing it's a major chord, or that sounds a little more down to me. I'm guessing it's a minor chord. So you're going to sort of reference your first impression by singing either singing in your head or literally a scale that is going to that you think is going to fit that chord. And then lastly, a dominant chord. So to me, that sounds, you know, quizzical. It sounds sort of in between. It's got its own personality. So I kind of encourage you, I definitely encourage you to listen to different chords, get with the piano and play some different ideas, and play these different chords on your horn that might be more readily available to you. And just get an idea. We're going to, in subsequent lessons that you see available to you in ear training, we're going to get more into this. But I wanted to give this to you as an introduction to just have a general idea of what these main three chord types sound like. So go ahead and play with those a little bit and try to put your own identifying idea or name to each of those three chord type sounds. And it'll, you know, it's funny, I thought of this when I was a kid. I think my teacher first gave me this idea when I was 12 years old, and I still think about it today. So if you've got your own little sort of code of how to identify a basic chord sound, it's going to be a big benefit for you. Alrighty, have fun.